गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स. आई एम अनिल भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल इसवा. वेलकम बैक टू अवर ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट मस्कुलर सिस्टम फ्रॉम चैप्टर 8, दैट इज बॉडी मूवमेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बोन्स, मसल्स एंड सेवरल अदर bony structure in our body. Now today we are going to discuss about the muscular system and the joints. So first of all, what is a joint? So the joint is a place where two bones are connected. A joint is a place where two or more bones are connected, like our elbow. So here one long bone from upper arm and two bones from our forearm connected here. So this is called a joint. Now comes the next term. What is a ligament? So ligaments are elastic band like structures. Elastic band, chaude patti jaisa, hai na, chauda patti jaisa band like elastic tissues structure which attach two bones, which attach two bones together. So a ligament is a elastic band like structure which attach two bones together. Tough flexible bands of elastic tissue. This is what ligament. So wherever this joint is there, it is covered by a tissue called cartilage, a rubbery tissue which don't allow two bones to hit each other. So these joints help our bones to move in one to other direction. Now comes the different type of joints. So there are two types of joints. One is fixed and the other is movable joint. Look at your skull. When we were discussing about skull, I told you that when a child is there, in the head of the child there were several bones, but gradually when the child will grow, all the bones are joined together, so and they form skull. So this is the example of fixed joints. Then comes our hip bone. Here also three bones joined together. So these are the example of fixed bones. So here there is very less amount of movement. Next comes the movable joints, means those joints which allow movement. So depending upon the type and extent of movement, they allow this movable joints can be divided into few more types. Number one here, this joint, this pivot joint. Number two, ball and socket joint. Number three, hinge joint. And number four, gliding joint. So again I am telling you, number one here, pivot joint. Number two, ball and socket joint. Number three, hinge joint. Hinge joint. And number four here, this is what? Gliding joint. We had already discussed these joints in class 5 also, but and today here also we will discuss about it. So first of all, let's discuss about this pivot joint here. So here in our vertebral column, a bone is standing like that and our skull is fixed on this, and this will can move like this. So it will allow a good amount of movement. So this is called pivot joint. Twisting movement, this is called pivot joint. sorry class. Next comes the ball and socket joint. So here this collarbone and from the back a triangular bone is there, and they form here a cavity, a hollow space. In this hollow space, this bone, this upper arm bone, is fitted like this. The space here created is like this, this, and this upper arm fixed in this like this, and it can move. You have seen in cricket bowler's ball. So this ball and socket joint allow this good amount of movement. So here and in your hip, where your thigh bone joined with your hip, this two bones, these two joints are called ball and socket joint. Then comes the elbow, that is hinge joint. So here it will open only in one direction. If it will open in other direction, no, then you will reach hospital and you have to go to visit a orthopedic doctor who will treat the bone. So here this is called hinge joint, and your knee also hinge joint, because they provide you movement in only one direction, like a door. Like a door. Next comes the gliding joints. Here one bone sits on the other bone and they glide on each other, slip on each other. So this is called a gliding joint. So this and the joint in ankle, this is, these two are gliding joint. Okay class. So these are the different type of joints which is present in our body. Now let's discuss about a little bit movement. So we all know that we people move from one place to another place. This type of movement is called locomotion. This type of movement is called locomotion. Except locomotion, we move our body from here to there. We move our fingers, we move our hands, we move our neck. So this is also movement. But if you move from one place to other place, it is called locomotion. So for that we have legs, and for moving our body parts one place to another place, we have joints. We have joints. Okay class, we have joints. Now let's discuss about one more term, that is called tendon. So tendon are tough elastic cord like tissue which attach muscles with the bones. Ligaments attach two bones together, and they are tough elastic band like structure. Here it is a cord like structures, and they attach muscles with the bones, and they both ligament and tendons help in the movement of the bone. How it will help in the movement of the bone? Let's understand. So here this my bicep and this tricep. So bones cannot move. When we want to move our bones like this forearm bone and upper arm bone, then what will happen? This muscle which is attached with the bone by the help of tendon, and this bone and this bone attached by the help of ligaments. So what happened? This muscle contract, my bicep will contract, bicep muscle contract. So what will happen when it contract? It will become stiff, it will become short, and it will pull the forearm towards itself, and this tricep muscle relax. When this tricep muscle, but this muscle cannot push it, it cannot push it, it only pull it. So now to move it in the original position, its normal position, this tricep muscle will contract and this forearm go, I mean this muscle contract and pull it to its natural position. So this is called antagonistic movements, means two pairs of muscles are present everywhere. One contract, other relax, one relax, other contracts. One relax, other contracts. One contracts, other relax. So this is called antagonistic movement of muscles, and this is how bones move, or we are able to move our body parts because of the antagonistic movement of muscles. So class, I hope you are able to understand about joints and muscular movement. If any problem, ask me class, I will help you. Have a great day. Be safe at home. Thank you.